has like 2 demerits today. So, okay, class. You have your slips of paper. Go ahead and turn them into the hat. Trevor, stop! Trevor, why do you have to bother courting all the time?
Maybe it's because he loves her.
Shut the fuck up!
Okay. All right. As you know, we're doing a little bit of a sex education unit, and because sometimes the questions that you ask might be a little hard to ask out loud, I had you anonymously put them into the hat so that I can read them out loud to the class. Yes, Mackenzie.
Miss Henderson, these questions are going to be anonymous, right?
Yes, like I said, even I don't know what they say. So it's going to be a surprise. All right. Okay, first question is, what is the vagina and should I be scared of? this is a very good question. Okay, so the vagina is the female reproductive organ. It's comprised of several parts, several regions.
Wait. You're telling me there are regions?
Yes, there are several regions. Like
okay,
I said,
I need to write this down. Hold on.
Okay, like I said, it's quite complex.
Oh!
Vulva and then. Okay, I'm just going to. Okay, this next one. How many candies?
It's supposed to say condoms.
How many condoms is too many condoms? Okay, this is an interesting question. I'm not really sure if I answer it. But what I do know is that condoms are very important in facilitating safe sexual encounters. So, good question, I guess. Okay. the next one is, what is the little dangly thing hanging in the back of my throat? That's called the uvula.
Okay, wait. You're talking about there's a uvula and a vulva?
Yes. The uvula is actually related to...
Oh, Trevor, stop!
What is happening? What is happening?
He didn't do anything.
He just put gum in the back of my hair.
No.
Trevor, you are so close to going to the principal's office.
Did you marry her already?
How do I stop having sexual fantasies about the American Revolution? I guess I would consider maybe not exposing oneself to the American Revolution.
Mackenzie!
What? Me? No! No, me? Fantasize about the American? No!
I saw you in gym class yesterday journaling about how you want Ben Franklin to kite. Ben Franklin to kite. Can I see you?
Shove it up your uvula, Rodney!
Okay. All right, class, calm down. We're going to move on. Goodness sakes. Okay. What is the proper way to use alcohol?
It's supposed to say anal beads.
Calvin, you were supposed to only submit one question.
I did.
Mackenzie.
Calvin got 2!
F. Mary killed George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, John Lincoln. I cannot answer this question, Mackenzie.
I didn't write it!
I just watched you.
Okay, but like, Mary George, fuck Hancock, and like, kill Jefferson.
Do you think Courtney knows I have feelings for her?
What? Who wrote that?
This is not related to sex education. I can't answer this question, but probably never. Courtney, just read it. When will Trevor realize that I find him repulsive? Once again, probably never, because you have no emotional intelligence. You're like 12.
Damn straight.
This one's about sex ed.
Do you think Courtney realizes how much my feelings are hurt by her constant rejection? Once again, no. These are supposed to be about sex education. I'm going to have to stop if we keep going through this. Courtney, I'm not reading this question out loud.
No, they're supposed to be anonymous.
Well, I can't read it, okay?
Okay, but I can. Why didn't Paul Revere specify on whom the redcoats were coming? Or how many people?
This has been entirely derailed. Okay? Trevor, what are you doing? Do not. You read your own stupid love letters.
I have a confession. For years, I've attempted to disguise my feelings of affection and, dare I say, lust for my classmate, Courtney Rogers, with obnoxiousness and aggressiveness, but that is because I am a man, and I can't come to grips with how to express my love in a way that's emotionally vulnerable, lest I be viewed in the eyes of my peers as a wuss.
There's so many red flags
but
here!
But now I realize that my love for you, Courtney Rogers, expands far outside of this corporeal plane, and in fact, extends into the far reaches of the celestial orifice from where we all were conceived.
Trevor, corporeal? You failed English last week. Okay, we're done here. We cannot be having this.
No, I have one more thing to say. Courtney Rogers, will you be my girlfriend?
No.
Real smooth, buddy.
All right, it's all right. We have one more question, just like one more. Okay, can we hang in for one more? Is it normal to want to date your potato?
It's supposed to say teacher.
Classic.
Off scenic Route 69.
Feel it, Angie's bone zone.
Is the premier bone collectors emporium.
Slash speed dating parlor.
In the greater metropolitan Kankakee area.
Yes, here at Feel it, Angie's bone zone, we are proud to offer the widest and highest collection of bone collecting and processing supplies this side of the Mississippi, all the way up to the Ohio River.
We've got bone cleaners, bone straws, bone saws, bone brushers, bone crushers, bony clams, and bone stems.
Yes, and if you're too much of a little baby bitch to deflesh, macerate, clean, and articulate your own little skeleton, oh, we got a wide variety of pre-processed bones for your pleasure.
Let them show the world what a nasty little bone freak you are, you little pussy bitty bitch, you. But let us do the work for you.
Yes, because if you might be surprised, because if you heard, I also said that we were a speed dating parlor. Very surprising, because here at Phil and Angie's Bone Zone, we are the premier bone collecting facility / speed dating parlor run by a married couple in the state of Illinois.
Oh, yeah. Here you will definitely find someone to bone. Also, you'll be able to find a long-lasting connection. Not like that other bone-collecting emporium / speed dating parlor on the border of Indiana, which is also run by a married couple, where you think you'll find a genuine connection while you're hip-deep in a pile of palaces, only for them to ghost you in your beautiful life, and then steal your fine little ideas for vertebrae storage, and then just kind of post about it on Instagram, and be like, look at us, we got a bone store too, and it's like, shut up, it was all your first!
I know, yes, if you're a villain, Angie's, if you ever go near Muncie, Indiana, we beg you to stay away from those ribcage racketeers over at Carl and Paul's Metacarpals and Meat Market.
If you go there and you see a shelf shaped like a spinal column full of spinal parts, I swear, you know, that was my
what?
Beautiful idea first, and then stole it. Also, while I'm at it, pray tell, Carl and Paul, that why a bone emporium / speed dating parlor would lead the public to believe that you're also selling meat. What? It's just supposed to be bones. That's the whole bit. Get it? Because it's bone and sex and fun. What?
I think the meat was dick.
Oh. They did have good dick.
Hey, do you want to get out of here and have super freaky nasty bone sex and fall deeply in love with each other?
Yeah, sounds great!
Thanks, Phil and Angie!
So if you're just looking for someone to enable your fetishes or just, you know, like, you know, go collect bones, then come on down to Phil
and the Angie's
Bone Zone!
Seriously, we got all this shit. We got a rat tail. We alligator hand rabbit foot.
So much in debt, it is not even funny.
Zip.
Zap. Zap.
Zip.
Zap.
Zop.
Zip. Zap. Zop.
Zip.
Zap.
Zop.
Zip.
Zap.
Zop.
Zip.
Zap.
Zap. No!
Player Andrew eliminated.
When you smiled at my creative bird dissection, everyone ran and looked for shelter while we wrote in blood on the wall, helter skelter. When I see you, my stomach is in knots. My blade in your skin, I'll play connect the dots. I can't handle it, you're too handsome, so let me love you. I perform. Promise you get used to the smell of chloroform. Throw you in an oven. Acid on the floor. Keep on kicking till your footprints are burned into the door. Determination doesn't falter. I made a shrine to you. It rivals Dahmer's altar. And I'll keep coming until you're a John Doe. I'm chasing you down like OJ's Bronco. I'll tie you up. Call you honey, look in my eyes, same blue as Bundy. I am the hunter, you are the bait. You'll end up worse than Sharon Tate. The movie of our love is a thriller. The twist in the end is that I'm the killer. My heart can't handle it.
To believe that this is just a regular custom fit orthotic insert. Here's what you don't know. Go to the Hebrew letter Vav, which is the number 6. Short top, long tail. Short top, long tail. Big tits, long legs. What does this have to do with anything? Numbers tell a story. Let's take the number 6 here and multiply it by 1. What do you get? 6. Take that 6, multiply it by 2. What do you get? 12. Take that 6 and multiply it by 0. What do you get? 0. That means nothing. Just forget about that part. But now we have 6 and 12. Rearrange those numbers and what do you get? 216. 216. What is 216? It is 6 to the 3rd power. And how do you write 6 to the third power? 6 times 6 times 6. You get 666. But maybe this 120 number has nothing to do with that. Maybe it is a reference to the book of Revelations, chapter 12, verse 0, and then a great and mysterious sight appeared in the sky. There was a woman whose dress was the sun, who had the moon at her feet! Don't believe me, huh? What about this 5-in-1 action? Is that really for clinically proven pain relief? No! 5 points in 1. 5 in 1. 5 in 1. Short top, long tail. Big tits, long legs. Witchcraft. Do you know the symbol of the Antichrist? Anyone? Anyone? No? It's an upside down cross. Do you want to know what the Bayer logo is? It's a cross. No, the cross is upside down! And the devil climaxes! And the devil, he's a sneaky little bitch, and he sneaks his way into the sneakers of our youth. And a lot of people ask me, why would a devil do this with a foot treatment? Because the devil is after your soul! He has a foot fetish. Why are all those people always washing their feet in the Bible? To cleanse their soul of the devil. And the devil cries. And God laughs hysterically. And Jesus gives you a sensual foot rub.
Pretty transparent sorts, I am.
Ignoring that, everyone, Spirit,
you can tell.
Are you buried near or far?
F-A-R.
Jeez, guys, just, he's admitting it.
Martin, this is serious.
I am like the most serious person I know, so like, it's.
Come on, focus. We have to let the spirit move on.
Oh,
oh my
gosh.
God.
What is that smell?
It's like Dearman Hansen as a smell.
I had COVID last year and I completely lost my sense of smell, but I can smell that.
Oh my God, Martin, I think
just shit your pants. I guess he did.
Seriously?
No! You pooped your pants!
What?!
I didn't poop my pants! The ghost pooped my pants! I didn't know I pooped the ghost! I didn't poop my pants! Big boys don't poop their pants!
Silence! You have awakened Bruno! Do you wish to know my secrets?
Yes! Yes, Bruno, please! Tell us the spirit and the secrets to the afterlife! Is there a heaven? Is there a hell?
Hold on! Did Martin poop his pants?
No. What?
No!
Martin did shit his pants!
What?! Bruno! Is there a religion? That is, like, kind of accurate.
I have answered one question. My powers are exhausted.
No!
The spirit world is calling me back!
No, don't come back!
God damn it. There goes my Saturday night. Bye.
Yeah, I guess I should go too.
I like walking.
Spirit? Does Sam like me?
No.
And now, a look inside Jack's mind.
Yar, nothing but smooth sailing on the seas of being productive today. Oh no! Monkey, get away from me, monkey! No! Help me! Please help me! I need to get some work
inside Jack's mind.
Show you something real quick. I'm sure your dad will love it.
Oh, color me intrigued.
Shut up! Meet Billy!
Oh, you have a big mouth Billy Bass. That's cool.
Cool? I don't think you get it. I made her. She's a fully automated bass. She does everything.
So she like dances and sings a little
Just
bit.
Just strap on in, because I'm about to blast your ass off.
Excuse me?
Hey, Billy, do that sweet thing that you do. Oh, yeah. You're good.
Okay. I think I should probably go.
Why? I was just about to show you my waterbed.
Oh, I, can you just get the fish to stop?
Fish, turn off the music. Good bass.
Thank you, big fish daddy.
Oh, Andrew, I don't think this is gonna work.
What?
I mean, when I came over, I thought we would maybe have a drink or watch a movie. I didn't think I would be pressured into a threesome with your robot.
Well, that's on you! She's a big mouth. I can't control her urges. No, Billy! Too quick! Billy, it wasn't time for that yet. Bad bass! Naughty bass! Don't make me get the... Oh, no, Billy.
Yeah, I'm gonna grab my...
Shut up, woman! Can't you see I have a battered bass on my hands? She's nurturing. Get out of my bungalow. Billy, stop. I'm sorry I snapped at you. I didn't realize until this date with this human woman. But Billy, I love you.
Under the sea. Under the sea.
Darling, it's better. Down where it's wetter. Take it from me.
Go fill up the tank.
Oh, yeah.
Any experience you have had with ghosts?
Yes.
Oh, do you mind sharing a little bit about your experience?
Yes, I will share a little bit about my experience.
Thank you. I'm hooked. We are ready when you are. Take your time.
I was by myself in a room one time, and then somebody said something.
That's how they get you.
What did I say? What did I say? Tell us what they said.
The words are going to mean a lot here.
They were right behind me, and they went, yoo-hoo.
Yoo-hoo.
And I turned around, and there was nobody there.
God damn.
They were playing a little game with you, weren't they?
Or they were flirting with me.
Or they were
Just want milk?
Yeah.
Yeah. What person got that? Mm-hmm.
Would you believe it if we told you that you are haunted right now? You know how I...
It's a fact.
Yeah.
You know how I can tell?
How?
You see this t-shirt you're wearing that says Chipotle. If you can't see it, it says Chipotle. Now, when you consume Chipotle, it stays inside of you for a long time.
That is true.
Amen. And I can tell about, like, in this region, that you have a little bit of, like, upset. Right? You haven't felt right for a long time.
Yes, you're telling me about my whole life.
Oh, I mean, that's why we're here to help. That's what we do.
We know.
Yes.
Okay, so what we need you to do to get rid of the spirit that's inside of you is to say, like, pretend you're eating a burrito. Come on, come on.
Everyone,
grab your burrito.
Yeah,
okay.
We can use all the
two-fister.
Yeah, it's a big one. It's a big one.
And go away, go away, Chipotle.
Ready?
Go away, go away, Chipotle.
Again!
Go away, go away, Chipotle.
There is an energy in this room.
I'm trying to help him, Gale. I told him we should drink milk and not eat Chipotle.
Exactly. But Chipotle will always get you. Even the Sofritos!
Oh my God, Gale, not even the afterlife can I get rid of you.
You'll never get rid of me. You are a ghost. You can't bother me. You can't fucking touch me.
Oh, do you want to bet, Gale?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I do, Tebow. You're powerless. You can't do anything.
Right.
Ah. Oh. Oh shit!
Oh, okay. What is happening?
I think the ghost of Tebow is fucking gay.
Oh shit!
Richie, I'm so sorry you had to see that. Look away.
Bless your heart.
So much for volunteering your time and your energy, and we just wanna, you know, say we're here for you. Haunted Savannah Spirit Smashers, right? Can we give him a big round of applause?
What?
assess.
Eat cartridges are not sold in stores or anywhere else.
Don't buy other brand products. Buy our brand products that do the same things, but differently.
Tell them about your background, sister.
Oh, yes.
How does every court system treat you?
Oh, I have been held in contempt of court and every court on the instancy board.
We have entrepreneurial laws are determined to make your life better, but in a different way.
Yes. Did you know that we have a streaming service?
Yes. It is called Bingo Boss.
It has all of the same sports, movies, and TV shows as other streaming services, but ours is actually different!
It has none of the original audio!
Yes, it's all dubbed by an 89-year-old Ukrainian farmer.
It's the same!
But different
and illegal!
It's just a storm. I stand corrected.
Oh my god, it's the boogeyman!
Whoa! I'm sorry, kids. I thought this was the bathroom.
Wait, Dad, what are you doing here?
You're supposed to be in jail.
Oh, okay. Come on. What? Well, did your mama tell you that?
Yeah.
Okay. Look, I'm not in jail. I'm in federal prison. There is an enormous difference. All right? And me and the guards are just playing a little game of hide and seek. And I'm hiding.
Cool.
I can tell you where all the best hiding spots are in the house, Dad.
Well, actually, Janice.
It's Emily.
Right, Emily. I'm just here to grab some clothes and some money from your mom's purse. Don't scream. You'll wake up your mother. She turned me in once, she'll do it again!
Dad, we're scared!
Could you stay with us until the storm goes away?
Oh, look, kids, I don't really have a lot of time, alright? I'm on a tight clock. I know I don't see you guys a whole lot, but...
Yeah, Dad, you know, we never see you anymore now that you're in the clink.
It would be great to have a dad again. At least for tonight.
Oh. Fine.
Yay!
Can you read us a bedtime story like you used to?
Sure, you got any favorites?
Oh, this one.
Where in the world is David Miscavige's wife?
No, read this one.
Judy Moody goes to the dentist, but not before taking down the patriarchy. Okay, I'm not reading any of these. How about I tell you kids a real story?
Like the Odyssey?
No.
Or the narrative of the life of Frederick Douglass?
No. I'm thinking more like a story of how I met your mother.
That seems a little derivative, Dad.
Oh, well, it's all I got time for.
But doesn't a story like that usually take 9 seasons?
Not this one, Stacy.
Emily.
It was a dark and stormy night. Much like the night, all right? I was cast as an ensemble dancer in the musical Black Hawk Down on Ice. We were playing in Fort Lauderdale at a formal barbecue restaurant that also had a dinner theater. Now, when our Zamboni driver got caught with flesh-eating virus and incidental high blood pressure and died, your mom was brought in from the local ice rink to be the backup Zamboni driver.
Zamboni? But, Dad, that's my middle name.
Oh, that's because you were conceived in one.
But what happened to you and Mom, Daddy?
I guess we just drifted apart. You know, those first couple of years, they were full of such passion and love, and eventually it's just replaced by boring, by-the-numbers makeup sex, which starts with emotionlessly making out, and followed by just taking off your socks. And of course, it's occasionally interrupted by sudden plot developments in the Orange is the New Black episode that we have playing on in the background. Now, your mom, she decides to try and spice things up a little bit by going downriver, but I am suddenly drawn towards an open bag of goldfish on the nightstand in front of me, which I slowly begin to eat whilst throwing out an occasionally an intermittent fake, but slightly convincing moan of approval. Now, she gets done with her business down there, but I'm not done with my goldfish, okay? And then, of course, she decides to interject by saying, hey, what's this little pockmark that you got down here? Now, people who know me best know that I basically had a rash down there ever since an unfortunate ice hockey incident in the fifth grade. And I say, that's always been there. What are you talking about? He's like, she's like, it's not always been there. Do you have an STD? I'm like, I don't have an STD. You know I didn't graduate from college. And she said, no, an STD, a sexually transmitted disease. And she says, you've been sleeping with that waitress from Carl's Jr. again, haven't you? And I said, you mean your sister? And of course, that causes her to go all the way to the bathroom. And of course, I decide to take a look down there and see for myself. And I'm like, oh my gosh, is this a new rash? Or is my lower part of my body just a different color than my upper part? And of course, she eventually comes back, takes the pillow, and goes to sleep on the couch downstairs. The end.
Well, Dad, we missed stories.
Oh, and I missed you guys. Oh, that's my cue, kids. I better be going now.
Wait, Dad. Will we ever be a family again?
Of course, buddy. One of these days, they're gonna catch the real guy that ran over your mom's lover. And I'm gonna apply for full custody of you both.
Yay!
All right, good night, Jason. Good night, Chrysanthemum.
Emily!
Whatever.
you. Worries.
Oh, no. No worries. Sit down. I got you margarita.
Oh, thank you. Question. Do you always conduct your business with new clients here?
At Margaritaville? I mean, I just really love it here. Oh my god, did you want to go somewhere else?
Oh, no, I've never been to a Margaritaville, so it's new for me.
I mean, the vibe here is just great, and right now, during this whole renaissance of unemployment, it's really the only place that is more than 50% staffed.
Oh.
I wonder why that is.
Probably the endless margaritas! And they have a live band with a Jimmy Buffett impersonator!
They look miserable.
I mean, they're probably just overworked. But let's get down to business. Why do you want to sell to our company?
There are a myriad of reasons. First off, I think your company's brand persona is top.
Margaritaville, 5 o'clock, food?
I don't think we're gonna do any food, but two more margaritas would be great.
No, I didn't finish my first one.
Oh, but you will. It's 5 o'clock somewhere, am I right?
Bueno.
Okay, sure, yeah. Can I actually not get salt on mine?
Bar's not gonna like that.
Can I still not get salt on mine?
Yeah, let me drop some straws for you.
What an unfriendly woman.
I mean, she's probably just overworked. Now, back to my question.
Yeah.
What do you think a good price range is for selling your assets?
Right, so, normal in my eyes.
What the fuck did he ask for?!
What was that?
Him! It was him!
What?
Whoa! So you're the guy who doesn't want selling his margarita, you little pussy baby bitch?
I have blood pressure. If I have salt, I'll die.
I'll more salt on your grave!
What the fuck?
Oh, it's okay, John. Just chill. Sit back down.
That was insane.
I mean, they're probably just overworked.
All right. One with salt.
Thank you.
One no salt.
Oh, wait. No, stop right here. I'm an obnoxious white man and I need to speak to your manager.
She's not gonna like that.
I don't care. Bring her out. She's going. Okay.
Yeah, one more round would be great. Thanks.
What is this place even? What is this place even? I think they might be prisoners here. Oh, you must be the manager. I have been in your establishment for no more than, I'd say, 5 minutes, and I have been met with nothing
but...
She's not human!
I mean, it's 5 o'clock somewhere!
What the fuck does it do with anything?!
I think they're just overworked!
I cannot spend another moment in this Jimmy Buffett's culinary nightmare!
Wait, no! You just gotta enjoy the ambiance!
The ambiance? What the fuck is the ambiance here?! Half the TVs are playing reruns of America's Funniest Home Videos when Bob Saget was still the host! The other half are promoting a bone business, I think. It seems very, oh my, very, very adult. And what the fuck is the theme of this place even? Is it shirts, no shirts, shoes, no shoes, what's up? And these guys, that guy is not even touching his strings. Jeez, that man is not actually playing the guitar. How do you not see how weird this is? It's insane. We're in a nut house, I think.
Now you've done it.
The fuck you just say, man? Just chill out, man.
No, I was just saying, God. What am I doing? What am I saying?
Succumb to the vibe, John.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Congrats, John. You surrendered to love and came out clean on the other side.
I just shit my pants, bro.
and I need to leave.
No, wait, John. Before you go, I need to ask you one question before my business can go through the process of your buying your assets.
Sure, what?
Will you be my boyfriend?
No!
Dang!
Do you guys want to come down there? I'm on my way down there. Facebook at Tragic School Bus Comedy. Tragic School Bus. Don't be confused by that. That like it's this little kids channel. That yeah, that's
no,
the email.
No,
yeah,
I don't know that.
Yeah. But thank you for coming again, and we'll have a show sometime. We'll let you.